Hi, my name is Wafi Ahmed and I'm presenting our work, The Transformer-Based Approach for Source Code Summarization. This is a joint work with Shoiko Chakraborty and Baisakhi Wei from Columbia University and my advisor Kaiwei Chang from UCLA. Source code summarization refers to the task of creating human-readable summaries that describe the functionality of a program. With the progress of natural language generation using neural sequence-to-sequence learning, recent approaches in literature frame code summarization as translating a piece of source code into a short natural language description. For example, given this Python source code snippet, a code summarization model should be able to generate a summary similar to the human written summary. In this work, we study the transformer, a sequence generation model that has been found effective in many natural language generation applications but hasn't been explored in source code summarization. A notable amount of prior work in source code summarization has leveraged recurrent neural networks to learn source code representations. Transformer, in contrast, entirely relies on the self-attention mechanism, which is well known for its effectiveness in capturing long-range dependencies. Such a characteristic is essential to learn program representations. Besides, the order of source code tokens play an important role in embedding the code structure into learned representations. Hence, in this work, we study different positional encoding schemes to find an effective way to encode the source code structure. We study the impact of three different forms of positional encoding in learning source code representations. The absolute position encoding scheme treats source code as a linear sequence of code tokens, while the relative position encoding considers source code as a fully connected graph, either directed or undirected. We show an example here. For the expression A plus B, absolute position encoding uses the tokens indexed to form their respective position representation. On the other hand, the relative position encoding models the pairwise distance between code tokens. We consider two variants of relative position encoding, where in one variant, we compute relative distances based on whether a token is on the left or right of the target token. In the second variant, we simply ignore the direction, treating the source code as an undirected graph. We conduct experiments on two well-studied datasets in Java and Python programming languages collected from GitHub. The datasets are pre-processed following a prior work. In an additional pre-processing step, we sub-tokenize the source code tokens based on camel keys and its snake keys that improve summarization significantly. We use Blue, Meteor and RouGL score as evaluation metrics. We compared the transformer with six state-of-the-art approaches as baselines that utilize RNN-based sequence-to-sequence learning. The baseline approaches model different forms of knowledge about source code, such as abstract syntax tree structure, API knowledge. They also cover a variety of techniques, including reinforcement learning and dual learning. In this work, we consider a simple setup, where the transformer takes the source code as input and learns to generate the summary with supervised training. The overall results show that transformer outperforms all the baseline approaches by a significant margin. Next, we show the impact of using absolute positions while encoding source code tokens and the words in the natural language summary. Encoding the absolute position of the summary is necessary as the transformer learns to generate summaries word by word. In contrast, we can see that the use of absolute position encoding for source code hurts the performance, which illustrates that treating source code as a linear sequence of tokens is not accurate. Since source code has a non-sequential structure, we hypothesize relative position encoding for source code tokens would result in better code representations that can improve summarization. Our experimental findings prove our hypothesis. In this bar plot, we compare the two forms of relative position encoding, where in one form, source code is treated as a directed graph, while in another, it is considered as an undirected graph. The results suggest that source code should be viewed as a directed graph. In other words, while modeling the pairwise relationship between code tokens, whether a token is in the left or right of the target token should be emphasized. In this work, we study transformer for source code summarization that outperforms state-of-the-art approaches. The code for reproducing the experiments is in GitHub. We hope our work would be considered as a baseline in future works. Being said that, thank you for listening.